Hey guys, welcome back to Q&A with Stiffy and I, who play Paul and Leo. Thanks again for all your questions, and we're going to get into round two.
Yes.
So, who's kicking? Oh, I'm kicking off this.
Yeah, you go and you ask the first one.
All right, Stiffy.
Yep.
Can you get Donna back in, please?
Yes. I don't know if I can. Would she like to come back? She'd probably do a little cameo. I think the whole world would like to see Donna back in here, and not as Tonya, and not as Leo Frenadio's girlfriend, but as the lovely Donna. No, I don't know the simple answer to that. She's a huge Hollywood star now, so the likelihood of her coming back into the show is probably... It's me now. Okay, Timothy, would you like Leo to reunite with Mishti or try something real with Chloe?
Oh.
Or find someone new? Because it says here, Leo needs some love.
Oh, that's sweet. That's sweet. Thanks. Yeah. It's a good question. I'd probably say definitely, I think Leo and Chloe had really good chemistry.
Yeah.
They were kind
of... You were both tall, so that worked.
Both great height, great height, and also both kind of similar in personality, go-getters, really into business, didn't mind bending the rules a little bit, but mischievous.
I love her character. It's great.
Yeah. Heaps of fun.
Actually, you two guys were really good together.
Yeah. It was
what
a lot
happened
of fun.
There?
I don't know why. You
it was the whole
it.
Boss
it
employee
fault.
Thing,
yeah.
Wasn't it? Oh, was it me?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
You made us end
I'm just hopeless, aren't I? Can't see a good thing, can't recognise a good thing when I see it. Anyway, there you go. So, but the answer is you'd rather like to get back with Chloe.
Yeah.
All right, let's rip Chloe.
Dynamite.
I mean that in the colloquial Australian
Although
sense.
It is sad because that Mishti was lovely too.
Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe further down the track, a bit of Chloe and then back.
Yeah. Mishti. Was that my outside voice then? Sorry.
Stefan, I've got one for you.
Yep.
What are the main differences, similarities, filming on the Neighbours set now to the 80s? And which co-stars do you miss the most?
The differences between the sets now and the sets in the 80s was, in the 80s, with the cameras we had then and the lighting and the technology available then, you used to walk into a studio and you could see everything. Sure. Now you walk into a studio and it's like, because we have these super, super light sensitive cameras now. And it actually is the first time we started using them, which was the beginning of this year. We were all making jokes all over the place in the studios, because jokes about not being able to see, because it literally was. It was 1/8 of the light that we used to shoot in. And it really does. We got quite a shock. It was like, has somebody forgotten to turn on the lights or something? That's probably the biggest difference. The other difference is it's still sets in a studio. So, you know, sets are sets. Just they've moved with the times, I guess. You know,
a little revamp.
Fashionable changes. What do you call it? You know, decorative changes with the times. But they're still... They're still the same sets. And the thing about it is, they are actually still the same sets. Believe it or not, we are still using the same sets that we used in the 80s. They have just been redressed, repainted, you know, a couple of things reconfigured here and there. But it's like that one, I think, used to be Mrs. Mangles. Which you can't see. I'm pointing over there and you're going, what's he pointing at? I'm pointing at what used to be Mrs. Mangles' set. And that one over there used to be Harold's, I think, yeah.
Huh.
And it's just been revamped, but it's still the same layout, everything. And this is probably one of the biggest dramatic changes, is the bar, because I don't even... Oh, no, we had the water hole in the 80s, didn't we? And it used to be called... it was either called Jack Lasseter's or... Oh, I can't remember. I can't remember that far back. Was I alive then? Okay. Right, this is one for both of us.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, hey. It says here, Maddie Wilson asks... Why do you all forget to clean the coffee machine? Maddie.
You traitor.
Who's not cleaning the coffee machine? I meticulously clean the coffee machine, even though there's two of them now. I only use one. Make sure I have it all timed out. So I do my coffee and then I do my milk. And while I'm putting the milk back in the fridge, I'm giving my coffee just a 10-second ping in the little microwave just to make it hot, because I like hot coffee, and wipe it down.
Do you do the flush out with the milk? You know, the...
Oh, yeah, yeah, if I have to, yeah, but see? So who are you pointing the finger at, Maddie? Me?
You're on dish duty.
Coffee cleaners, coffee machine cleaners. We'll suss them out for you. Ooh. We'll find them, Maddie. We'll get to the bottom of this.
This is a good one, Stiffy. Okay. A really good one. When is Paul hooking up with Sheila? I think they make a perfect couple.
They do! They've hooked up a couple of times, literally. Well, not hooked up, wrapped up. Who remembers that? Who remembers the great cling wrap scene? We all do. Yeah, that's probably never going to happen. But then, who knows? Never say never. As I said to Tim before, it's a soap. Anything can happen.
Anything
we love working with Colette. And it's pretty well-known knowledge now that Colette and I go back a long, 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 long time ago because we used to both be in prison. Well, she was a long-time regular in prisoner, and which you called prisoner cell block H over in the other parts of the world. And I played her young boyfriend for about a month and a half or something on the show with lots of hair, lots and lots and lots of hair. Look it up. YouTube it. While you're doing this, once you finish this and you press the subscribe button, nip over and have a look at some old prisoner scenes with me and Colette. So we actually do. We have a good history together. And it was really odd that they sort of comically got us back together for a little while and this. Yeah. No, it's good. She's good fun. But don't hold your breath.
All right.
We love the comedy and you can't have that comedy if you got... Well, I suppose Susan and Carl do, don't they?
It's hard for Paul to have that, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, there you go. Sorry, go on. I interrupted.
No.
Go.
It's your turn.
Oh, it's my turn.
Yes.
I'm so good at this. Right. Tim, if you weren't an actor, what would you be?
I'm not sure. Ooh. I'm not sure. Maybe I'd get into a bit of music or something in the arts.
You play, really, don't you? You're...
A little bit of guitar and I used to sing in a band. So I'd probably revisit that and try to fine tune that.
Yeah, but that's even more fickle than acting, though, isn't it? Trying to get in the music biz.
Yeah.
So you'd kind of need a backup. What would be your backup?
Backup? I don't know.
Working the tech counter at Meijer.
Yeah.
You never know what you're going to be. You know, astronaut, perhaps?
Yeah, that would be awesome, actually.
That's what my young son wants to be. He's dead set. He wants to be an astronaut. He wants to work on ISS.
Oh.
Yeah, International Space Station.
Yeah.
You knew that.
Yeah.
He
I was thinking of
me.
The other...
oh, no, that
yeah,
one.
Yeah.
There you go.
Well, thanks for watching, guys. And please don't forget to just subscribe on YouTube. And we'll see you again soon for the next installment of the Q&A.
If we're still here.